Well, good morning. 2011 was the best year for traffic safety in New York City in more than 100 years. In fact, the 243 traffic fatalities our city endured last year was the lowest number since records started being kept back in 1910. And in 1910, most people went by horse-drawn carriages. The number of New Yorkers who died as a result of a traffic crash last year was nearly 40% lower than it was in 2001. Let me repeat that, 40% lower. The number of pedestrians who died as a result of being hit by a car was dramatically down too, 31% down since 2001. And on a per capita basis, New York has two-thirds fewer crashes than the nation as a whole, further solidifying our standing as America's safest big city. Now, some have responded to these safety gains, waiting for the train. Some have responded to these safety gains by saying that we now have better engineered cars, faster ambulance response time, and better emergency hospital care. And all of that is true. But maybe the most telling stat is the number of accidents where any injury occurred, and that has been cut from nearly 80,000 a year back in 2001 to about 50,000 in 2010. Think about that, nearly 30,000 fewer injury crashes a year, an undeniable demonstration that smart government policies and aggressive enforcement really can make an enormous difference. And based on preliminary data, we have good reason to believe that New York has had even fewer injury crashes in 2011 than in 2010. Compared to the 10 other largest U.S. cities, New York ranks as the safest with a fatality rate less than half their average. Now, today we are announcing our latest measures to build on our city's traffic safety gains. This block between Roosevelt and 39th Avenues will become a gateway, one of 13, to New York's newest neighborhood slow zone. And like the first slow zone we created in Claremont in the Bronx last November, it is being established in response to concerns from members of the community, and it was recently endorsed by Community Board 3. Work to create this new zone began last month and will be completed by late summer. It will cover a roughly 35-square-block residential neighborhood that includes two schools and 10 pre-kindergarten or Head Start locations. And as you can see, the entrances to the slow zone will have eye-catching blue gateway signs to alert drivers that they are entering a reduced speed area from 30 miles an hour down to 20 miles an hour. And we're installing 14 new speed bumps to make sure drivers observe the new limit. We've seen great success with our first slow zone in the Claremont section of the Bronx. Their speed bumps effectively reduce speeds at reduced speed at 6 out of 7 locations where they were installed. Currently, applications for 4 neighborhood slow zones have been approved by community boards, and 9 others are pending review. And the city's Department of Transportation will continue working with community boards, residents, and other local groups to create more slow zones. Slow zones are just one of our efforts to make New York City streets safer by improving road design and enhancing traffic safety. We've also created new pedestrian plazas in Times Square and Herald Square as part of our Green Light for Midtown initiative, and we're planning safety redesigns of streets that have tragically seen too many deadly crashes, such as Adam Clayton Powell Boulevard in Harlem and 4th Avenue in Brooklyn. Since 2002, we've installed more than 1,500 speed bumps citywide. But speed bumps aren't always feasible, so we've installed flashing lights and signs in school zones and other reduced speed areas. We've also installed some 280 lane miles of bike routes in all 5 boroughs over the last year. And our pedestrian safety report and action plan shows that streets with bicycle lanes are not only better for cyclists, they're also 40% less deadly for pedestrians. We've also created safe streets for seniors in neighborhoods with large senior population that includes such changes as extending pedestrian crossing times and shortening crossing distances. We're currently on track to install pedestrian countdown signals at 3,000 intersections across the city, and we have red light cameras operating at 150 intersections throughout the city. We continue to seek authorization for more from the state, and our administration continues to look for ways to work with Albany on installing speed cameras. And I would like to thank State Senator Andy Lanza and Assemblymember Deborah Glick, who are co-sponsoring a bill that would allow us to install speed cameras, for their leadership on this important issue. In addition to better engineering, we're also encouraging safer streets by educating New Yorkers to the dangers of speeding. For example, last year we launched the That's Why It's 30 campaign to remind drivers of the city's 30 miles per hour speed limit. We're also working with teachers to ensure that our kids know the basic ways to stay safe both inside of cars and out. And finally, we're building upon the advances in engineering and education by better enforcing our traffic safety laws. The NYPD focuses enforcement on the violations that most often cause serious injury and death, including drivers and passengers who are not wearing seat belts and drivers who text or talk on cell phones without a hand-free device. More than 300,000 moving violation summonses were issued last year in those two categories alone, and the NYPD's focus on those who drink and drive resulted in over 8,000 arrests and seizure of 900 vehicles. Now, keeping streets safe for motorists, cyclists, and pedestrians is one of the most important public safety challenges any government faces, and neighborhood slow zones like the one we're visiting today are helping us to meet that challenge. And I would like to welcome the woman who's making our administration's efforts to make New York's 6,300 miles of streets even safer, Commissioner Janette Sadik-Khan. Janette.
Thank you, Mayor Bloomberg. Well, thank you. It is great to be here with our fabulous borough president and council members Ferreras and Vacca, Assemblyman Moya, Chief Tuller, and all of our partners in safety. Are we waiting? Talk to Joe Loda about that. Corona is like a lot of neighborhoods in New York City. It's filled with homes, it's filled with churches, schools, and lots of people walking, kids and seniors and families. And keeping these neighborhoods safe is a top priority for New York City DOT. And that's why we're expanding the neighborhood slow zone program citywide. Slow zones send a strong message to drivers that our neighborhoods are not shortcuts. And speeding on our streets is really a matter of life and death. A quarter of all fatalities in New York City, 60 a year, are caused by speeding. And we can do something about this. If you are hit by a car going 40 miles an hour, there is a 70% chance you will die. If you are hit by a car going 30 miles an hour, there is an 80% chance you will live. That is why the speed limit is 30. And that is also why we're running an unprecedented safety education campaign to educate New Yorkers on the dangers of speeding and getting the message out that speeding has deadly consequences. So today we're waiting for the MTA. So today we are continuing the fight to put the brakes on dangerous speeding with this 20 mile an hour zone. If you are hit by a car going 20 miles an hour, there's a 95% chance you will live. And with odds like that, it is no surprise that dozens of communities across the city are placing their bets on safer streets. We started this initiative last fall with the first neighborhood slow zone in the Claremont section of the Bronx. And the result, as the mayor pointed out, is that speeding is down, some 10% reduction in speeding, traffic is calmer, and the improvements have engendered rave reviews by the community. Corona has averaged 33 traffic crashes a year regularly in the area covered by this neighborhood slow zone. And there is no place for that kind of reckless behavior. There's no place for that kind of reckless behavior in an area with 2 schools, 10 daycare centers, all within a quarter mile area. And it's also no surprise that 2 weeks ago, Community Board 3 voted unanimously to support this slow zone in Corona. We'll be installing these blue gateway signs at 13 entrances to the zone to let drivers know that this is a special area and they need to take special care. We're gonna have 14 new speed bumps. We're gonna have 26 new speed limit signs, 21 locations with stenciled speed limit notices on the streets, all within the zones. And these treatments will be available for communities across the city, from Inwood in Manhattan to Borough Hill in Brooklyn, Riverdale in the Bronx, and Rosebank in Staten Island. And we're gonna continue our push to get speed camera legislation passed, and wanna thank our elected leaders in Albany, particularly Assemblymember Glick and Senator Lanza for their help in that regard. We are reminded every day about the tragic consequences of reckless driving. Just over an hour ago, a DOT contractor working on the Grand Central Parkway was killed by a reckless driver who was arrested for DWI. Our hearts go out to his family. These are tragic consequences. The tragedy that comes from reckless driving is something that we need to do something about every day. We cannot take our safety gains for granted. And we need to keep working on every front every day, whether it's speeding, whether it's drunk or distracted driving. We have to do everything we can to continue to see the improvements that we've seen on the streets of New York. I also want to thank Commissioner Kelly and Chief Tuller for their support of their important safety initiatives, and again, thank Mayor Bloomberg for his leadership on traffic safety in New York City.
Janette, thank you, and our prayers do go out to the family of the worker who was killed, and it just goes to, once again, I don't know how many times we have to be reminded, drinking and driving don't mix. We certainly would not be where we are today in keeping our city safe without the work of outstanding NYPD leaders like Chief of Transportation Bureau, James Tuller, and I would like him to say a few words. James? Chief?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. And thanks to Commissioner Khan and Councilwoman Ferreras and all those that brought. I got to get my rhythm on this one. And thanks to all those that were involved in bringing the slow zone to Corona, the 115 precinct. The NYPD and its precincts continue to focus on traffic strategies to ensure the safety of the residents and visitors of the city of New York. Briefly, let me explain how we do that, and I'll do that very briefly. I want you to be aware that each of our precincts, the 115 precinct, has a traffic team. The traffic team is headed by the executive officer of the precinct, who is a captain. That traffic team is brought up to police headquarters to a traffic stack meeting. So throughout the city, we bring up an individual borough, we bring up the precincts and their traffic teams, and we discuss the traffic strategies. Mayor Bloomberg, in his remarks, talked about enforcement, education, and engineering. That's exactly what's discussed at traffic sets. So the precincts put their strategies together, and it's discussed, and we arrive at the strategies. A lot of the input should come from the community. The slow zones, I'm glad to see, are based on community involvement. So at the traffic stat meeting, education is discussed. And when we talk about education, again, the mayor talked about that's 30 miles an hour in the city. That's the speed limit here in the city, 30 miles an hour unless otherwise posted. I think that's something that should be noted here, because that's an education process that I think that's extremely important. So that's something that discussed that traffic stat. Engineering is also discussed. So a lot of the remarks that both Commissioner Khan and the mayor discussed on engineering, discussed at traffic stat, with the borough commissioner from DOT. So all these things, including now the slow zone, will be a topic of discussion at our NYPD traffic stat meetings. So I'm just going to conclude by thanking everybody for certainly having the slow zone and all the other engineering and all the other traffic concerns that you bring to us, and we'll continue to focus on traffic safety here in the 115 precinct and throughout the city. Thank you very much.
Chief, thank you. Borough President Helen Marshall has been a strong partner in our efforts to keep Queens residents safer, no matter how they decide to travel, and I'd like to invite her to share a few words on today's announcement. Helen?
Thank you, Mayor Mike. First of all, you're keeping us healthy, those who listen to you, okay? Now you're going to keep us safe. And so I'm delighted to be here with Julissa Ferreras, who is the councilwoman now. I was the councilwoman, she's the councilwoman now, okay? But we have many children, many young children. We have two schools right here. And this whole area is very, very dangerous. This is one way coming this way, and it's very complicated. So some of the things that are going to have to be done are going to be structurally to make it a little safer for us to move around. Okay. I thank you, Mayor Bloomberg and Commissioner Sadik-Khan. Oh, that's nice. I like that. For developing this initiative, we must continue to make the safety of our residents a top priority throughout the city, in particular here in Corona, Queens. And we have people coming from all over the world who might live here. They have to get used to how it is, how you have to cross the street in America. You don't run for your life, but you do have to pay attention to the signs and the traffic lights. The Slow Zone initiative will help reduce car crashes and other accidents. Speed kills. We need to reduce the speed at which drivers travel, especially on roadways here in Corona that are filled with pedestrians and parents with baby carriages. Hopefully, we can continue to expand this valuable initiative throughout other parts of Queens, and I'm hoping that can happen. Thank you very much.
Helen, thank you. We have several legislators with us this morning who have been important partners in our administration's efforts to keep New York City streets the safest of any big city in the nation. And I would like to invite them to share a few words. First, we have Assemblymember Francisco Moya. Francisco.
Thank you. Thank you again, Mr. Mayor. I applaud you for your efforts to make our cities much safer and our streets safer for pedestrians to walk through here today. I also want to thank the commissioner for her great work in making sure that this becomes a reality here in our communities. And, of course, to my great councilwoman, Julissa Ferreras, for her initiative in bringing this to fruition here today. As someone who was born and raised here in Corona, Queens, who attended the school that you see across the street, I have to say that this is something that is much needed and something that I think the community applauds because of the fact that there's one thing that is indisputable here, and that's that speed kills. And we've heard so many stories throughout the city, but also here in this neighborhood, of people who have been tragically killed due to speeding. This will eliminate that. This will make our streets safer. This will bring the community the quality of life that it really needs and deserves here in Corona. And I just want to say thank you again for all of those who were involved in this and bringing this here together today. Thank you.
Assemblymember Moya, thank you very much. Next, Councilmember Julissa Ferreras. Julissa?
How are you? I am really, really excited to be standing here today. About 2 years ago, I started an initiative with the National Association of Latino Elected Officials, and it was a cohort on how to make our communities healthier. It was elected officials from across the country. And in those conversations was when I learned that it's not just about obesity and about diabetes, but it's also about getting our young people to walk the streets. And if they're going to be out there, they have to be in safe streets. So if we're asking our young people to move, we have to ensure that where they're walking is safe. I too attended PS19. I ran the Beacon School here for 6 years, so I understand firsthand how scary and traumatizing it is for a young person to cross the street and have a car rush up on them. And I think that that's what we're eliminating here. I'm really excited. It's been a pleasure to work with the administration on this project. And you know, a lot of communities asked for this, so I'm glad that we won. and that Corona is here and that we're going to be ensuring. And for those drivers that think that, you know, this could add a couple of minutes to your commute, it really makes a difference for a family that might lose a senior or a young person because we were in a rush. So we should slow down. This is a residential area, and I'm so grateful to be here today. And Corona is about slowing down, and maybe you could stop and get something to eat. Thank you.
Julissa, thank you. And Councilman Jimmy Vacca. Jimmy?
Thank you.
Wait, the 7 line is very punctual.
Yeah. Well, I first want to say that as chair of the Council Transportation Committee, I'm going to be hard put to criticize the MTA for inadequate train service after all that we've seen today. So they may have known we would be here. I thank the mayor and I thank Commissioner Sadik-Khan, but the reality is New Yorkers, look at your speedometer. When you drive, look at your speedometer. And before you complain about other people going too quickly, look in the mirror. Too many times people stop me complaining about speeding when they are, in fact, speeding. And I see that each and every day in my own district. People don't look at their speedometers when they drive to see how actually fast they're going. There's not a place I go to in this city where I'm not told by people that they insist on speed bumps. Yeah. They insist on four-way stop signs. They want traffic on their block and in their community to go slower. This is a real problem in this city with people who are going so fast, yet they have no idea why or where they're going. Something must be done. I support the attempts of our city, the commissioner and the mayor, to do things about it. I think the measures that they've outlined today are common sense. We have to do more. But ladies and gentlemen, slow down. That's the message that we hear today. Thank you.
Thank you, Jimmy. As I said earlier, neighborhood slow zones are created in response to requests from the community, and this new slow zone was approved recently by a unanimous vote of Community Board 3. And Community Board 3's chair, Marta LeBreton, is here. Marta, nice to see you. And the district manager, Giovanna Reid, and she's going to share a few words. Right? Right, you are.
Good afternoon, everyone. As the mayor said, I'm joined by the chairperson of Community Board 3, Marta LeBreton. By the way, she's a dynamic and wonderful, wonderful leader in this community. I'd like to thank Mayor Bloomberg, the commissioner, all of our elected officials, including the police department, for bringing about something that this community has needed for years. If you do not know, Community Board 3 is comprised of 250,000 residents. The majority of these residents are seniors and young people. So this measure will make a significant difference on the quality of life and safety for our residents. Hence, I want to thank all the parties involved for bringing this measure into fruition. Thank you, Mayor Bloomberg.
You're welcome.
Before we open the floor to questions, let me just summarize for our Spanish-speaking audience. Hoy empezamos una nueva iniciativa llamada Zonas Lentas. Estamos haciendo nuestras calles más seguras para peatones y conductores. En ciertas áreas de la ciudad habrá que reducir la velocidad a 20 millas por hora y hemos puesto en este 13 comunidades para mejorar la seguridad para todos los residentes. With that, we'll be happy to take